Max. How about now? How about now? Can you hear? Okay, so I guess quiet, huh? And now? How about now? I will just... Oh! So yeah, we should start now. So, welcome to the stream, everyone. Kadrin Chan, Doodling Girl, Joanna. Welcome, welcome. So, I unfortunately haven't finished the skeleton piece, but to compensate you two for that, I finished the Micro Mermaids. So yeah. Hey Sam! How are you? Oh, to answer your question, Joanna, I'm personally fine. It was quite a day at work, if I can say so. If I can say so. Lots of meetings, and gosh, some people are so stubborn, like really. But it's been mostly fine. I'm glad that I get this chat to work. I was so mad at this thing. And I'm super glad that I... You know what was wrong? I always forgot to scroll down and to accept the changes into the chat. And it was, each time, it was just going back to default. My day was good, it's just tiring. Those meetings can be tiring, like really. I will just adjust the chat a little bit because I see the messages. Because I see the messages kind of cut off. Now it should be alright. So, 50 minutes Monday today. I will just go to the page that I prepared for today. Oh, so it's here. I print out every picture so that when I show my sketchbook to anyone that they can see the reference. So yeah. I have no idea what this is. I think that it's some kind of jellyfish, but I am not sure. Jellyfish here look really different. Yeah, yesterday was crazy when it came to that, and I still haven't colored this skeleton piece. I only managed to color the Micro Mermaids. I will show you this again, especially for you, Sam. Yeah, the jellyfish do sting with their little tentacles. But the ones, the ones that are here are really small and they do sting, but not as painful. I don't know, I haven't been stung by a jellyfish before, but they are so small that you can grab a bowl of water in your hands and the whole jellyfish will fit there. And it looks so cute. And the jellyfish here, maybe I will find a picture. Because the jellyfish here, because the jellyfish here has so are so little and are so like, I will just download this real quick and I will show you this image. Can I like adjust it something? No. Oh, I can. Okay. I will just swap the pic real quick because, you know, I planned some football talk for today and I gathered some rather interesting material in that matter. So yeah, jellyfish in Poland look like this. And these are really, really tiny, but this little like flower pattern inside, it's like, it's the same color as my tank top today. And it looks so cute and they are so small and so yeah. So I have no idea. Oh, by the way, there is the first 30 minute Monday on this site because my sketchbook is chaotic like that. Where we shoot it late like this. Yeah, but aren't jellyfish more common in more salty water? Like the sea in Poland is like really, really not salty. It's not salty at all. Like if you happen to drink some, that you can feel that it's salt, but compared to other seas like the Northern Sea, even the most nearby sea, the adjacent sea to the Baltic Sea, is more salty than this one. And I think that in ocean it the level of saltiness is even more apparent because there are many I need to Google that word because I want to be I want to learn you some teach you something and I'm out of words. And I probably know the word, but I... Yeah, because there are many very narrow straits. Like, you know, the passages of water between the mass of land. And there are lots of many strains. In Denmark, which divides the Northern Sea from the Baltic Sea, and because of that the water don't mix well, and because of that the Baltic Sea is not salty at all. So there is very different fauna, and on top of that the Baltic Sea is pretty cold. It's so cold. Like, she found it in Florida. Whoa. Well, this kind of confirms my theory about the saltiness of water and other things like water temperature, which is correlated to the latitude, geographical latitude of certain area. So it seems like in, well, the flora and fauna kind of has to adapt to the to the conditions they have. It is? Sam, because I know you lived in Florida, have you seen those? Like the one on the photo? Because I haven't seen a jellyfish beach like in years. Probably only once in my lifetime. And the fact that it's just throw up to the shore, it's just yikes. So because my phone is doubling as a camera, I can't use a timer here, so I found a website that will time me online. So yeah, technology. I've never seen one of these in person, thankfully. That's good. So I think that first I will prepare some colors. I will stick to colored pencils because it's faster that way. And I see, oh my God, when I saw that picture, my first reaction was, what is that? And then my second reaction was, oh my God, all those sand grains and this texture is like, how can I recreate that? Like, really. So yeah, I have some palette here with just a dab of water and acrylic paint, because I found that it's the best way for me to get those highlights in case if I messed something. So I also brought some brush that I don't care about. So yeah, I will leave them on the side. I will not pour the paint by now because it will dry and it will be so much hassle. Yesterday I did the 7th 30 minute Monday. I will show you real quick. And I mixed the paint beforehand, but it was, first off, it was very little. Once I put everything, I noticed that I mixed too little paint. And once I mixed the yellow color, this cream color, and this peach, then, hello Machant, no, don't worry, you didn't, we are just like 15 minutes in, nothing interesting happens, just me rambling about jellyfish and about other stuff, and just telling, and I'm now just telling about painting this piece. And by the time I got to do the peach part, all the mixed paint just dried and all my mixing just were gone, and I had to mix it again. So I tried to be smart and save some time, but all in all, Your dad show it? You seen it? Whoa! I'm speechless. I don't know the word. Well, I'm really like very shy about my art to people in real life. So So yeah, knowing that someone in real life just outside the art community just like saw it and was like, whoa, it looks so pretty. I'm like, okay, thanks. Like, can I have my sketchbook back? So yeah, I tried to be smart and like sneakily mix the paint beforehand, and all in all it was just it didn't work out and I wasted time. So back to this little, where is it? I always tend to lose the pages. That's all, kids, order your drawings chronologically, not just like every other page and then come back like me. I can't find it. Where is it? Oh, here. So yeah. So there is a white paint ready to be squeezed out for highlights. Some water to dilute it because it's acrylic paint in white. So yeah, to dilute it so it would be like more smoother, because this is really old paint and it's really thick, like really thick, and I need to I need some water to dilute it. I also prepared white gel pen, but it doesn't want to work on colored pencils well, because I tried to make waves from not the last one, but the one from 2 weeks ago, which I also did yesterday. No, don't worry about the connection. If you can't do it right now, there's always, you know, replay or YouTube or anything else. Don't worry, don't really worry about the connection. I'm glad that you're here despite all the busy times in your life, because the exam season is really tough. I've been there. Back to the topic, because I intend to go horribly off topic when I start talking, and my mind just wanders off. I need to focus more. So this is some Donga gel zone. It's not a Sakura one, because I can't seem to get Sakura in Sakura gel roll in Poland in local art stores. I guess you can buy it online, but I haven't seen it either. Okay. No, don't worry, you can make art. Just I need to adjust the chat again, because this thing, like, but it doesn't work well on colored pencils. It works quite well on rougher texture, like on really chalky ones. Like, I need to see if I have some. I probably don't have the examples here, because it's still quite new sketchbook. But no. I did some there, and it seems to catch to the rougher texture quite well. Like the one that is made by Aether Inkwash, or watercolors or watercolor stencils. And it works kind of well. Sometimes works, sometimes don't, but I grabbed it, but I probably won't use it because it doesn't hold too well to colored pencils, because I tried and I failed. And I also had this thing. This is something my dad found I think it was in my grandfather's basement. This thing, I don't know if you can see this. This is dermatograph. And this is the crayon that is really waxy in texture. And it gives very smooth. It is supposed to, in theory, it is supposed to draw on any material, like on wood, on fabric, on metal, to, you know, just mark the places where you need to sew something or cut something or something else. And I found it really good to make highlights because it's really opaque. It's super opaque. Like I will just get to the last page, which is black. This is, by the way, the sketchbook that had checkered paper, but I took it off and replaced it with the paper that I glued some also spoiler alert that I glued some stripes with punched holes, and I put some toned paper, then I used blue etiquette or sticker paper to make the other side blue, because I like my sketchbooks double-sided. And I used some black paper because apparently I had so many black paper that I haven't used. And I used some black to get some other colors. And it was fine. And it is fine sketchbook. So it is really opaque. Like I'm not even trying. Compared to the gel pen. And to my white Faber-Castell. And also to my white watercolor pencil. I need to grab this real quick. Like really, this one, this is the opaqueness I need. In more than this form. I don't know. I have also this in, I believe in red. And in black. Probably in blue also, but I need to check this. I don't know if I swatch this because this is my sketchbook and I did some swatches of all materials I have, but the pages wrinkled horribly and I can't get the and I it it is I will write it in chat real fast. This is Polish pronunciation, and I will write quickly then. And I will quickly write how it would be in English. And they are supposed also to drawer on skin, but it doesn't. It doesn't do well. Maybe probably it's white and I'm already pale as this wall behind me. So I need to check real fast if I swatched it somewhere. And this is, by the way, my whole all my art supplies here. And I need to quickly check. No, I haven't swatched them because I thought probably that there were too little colors to be worth swatching. But these are pretty old. I looked for them in the net and they are from like 80s or 70s, probably back when my granddad was still alive, or I don't know, they were found somewhere by my dad. Thanks, Dad. So yeah, if you can find this, send me a link, because all I could find is that they are the one set I have with these like four or maybe five colors. It's like really old. It's like really, really old. And I hope to find them because the texture. This is kind of the texture, and it gives even if I will just swatch it also real quick, because crayons are usually super rough, especially on more textured paper. Like you see all the ridges of the paper, and this one fills the hole so nicely, and it layers really good. Like you can put some pink on top of it. Of course, you can't. Like these are a little bit like mix of crayon and oil pastels. Like, I haven't seen this thing before, and I love it because the highlights went so good with them. I used this one for waves. I will quickly show you the waves. I am a meme lord, but I don't like this meme. Sorry for any cringe or inconvenience. Where is it? Yeah, what did I said about putting things in chronological order? Yeah. So, I use them here to kinda smoothen the texture and to put some white on top of the rocks in places when I like here and also here to lighten this, and it layers on crayon so well. It's so smooth, nice, blended and lightened colors, like really nice. China graph pencils. Let me google that quickly. Yeah, when I look at the nibs, they kind of look like them. And I see that there is not so much color variety, which would be closer to what I know about them. Like, I think I have like really five colors. But thanks for sharing with us this very important information, like really. So yeah, I will be using this to layer some highlights or to smooth some texture. So yeah, and I will be using also my colored pencils, my Faber-Castell ones and my my Kohinoor aquarel ones, watercolor ones. Let me find this page again. Oh. So yeah, I will start gathering some colors, like white is a must. Maybe I will put them here so you can see them better. Maybe if I finish this, I will make a quick break and search for them, because I have all supplies that doesn't have a box. I ordered by color, so I think if I just rummage through the colors I saw on Google, which is like red, yellow, green, blue, white, well, not white, and black, that then I should find the ones that I own, and I can show them like closer, just bring some scrap paper and like do something with them. But I also plan to do some football player poses, like to work on some poses of a football / soccer player, whatever English you speak, you know. So yeah, just take the whole variety of blue, this like ochre, of course gray, black, because I see that those parts are pretty black, and what else, probably maybe this brown, but I know that this, maybe a little bit of gold. So yeah, this will be the colors I go with from the Faber-Castell set, and now from my Kohinoor, because they are kinda different. There is 24 of these and 24 of those, and the colors are really different. Need to sharpen this one. They lay kinda differently. They just, so I'll just grab these ones, but probably I will. How many of colors did I choose from each set? Like, I see that I will probably go with Kohinoor because they have more variety of blue. But I don't like the shade of gray here. So because I ran out of gray, and I seen that in my local art store they sell the crayons like outside the set, like you can just choose whatever color you are missing, and and the shade of gray, even though it's the same set and the same series. I will just, oh, And even though it's if it's the same series, like this shade of gray is much warmer than the one that ran out. So I'm going to add this Faber-Castell gray because it's much cooler. And this pink is already pretty cool. Like, it's pretty cool, like, on its own, because it's a deadly jellyfish. And I haven't seen this, but it's pretty cool, like, in the warmth of the colors. So, yeah, I will go with those. And also, I will quickly grab my pencil to just kind of measure and outline the jellyfish, because I think that proportions are the key here. I will try to make them as... Oh, I'm looking in my pencil case and I have this just right over here. Oh me. So yeah, I will just quickly sharpen this gray real fast. And I should be starting because, gosh, it's 40 past 8 here. I spent like 40 minutes on just talking and not doing. I should have this one done because... Okay, so what I like to do is to have all my supplies, like colors, in one hand and then switch this as I go. I don't know, it's kind of easier for me to start. So yeah, just adjust this real quick. Adjust myself so I won't be looking at this at the angle, because that wrecks the proportion like nothing else. So yeah, I will just go to the timer and probably get rid of the music, or maybe just lower the volume here and kinda make the volume up here so you will hear the music and I won't hear it, because this kind of music kinda distracts me. I prefer some other type of music and some other type of noises in the background when I draw. I'm so used to having like TV in the background. Yeah, I tend to go off topic so much. Like, if anybody was... I know that you, Joanna, and Sam were on my third stream when I kinda wander off and start talking about video games and history and like everything. And talking about everything other than the pick itself. Like, and I'm wasting time because I'm supposed to be drawing and I have rented the kitchen for like only 2 hours. So there's no time to rambling. When I have to get stuff done in 2 hours, like, really. But yeah, after that I will make a little break and then search for like more craft paper so I can practice the poses there, and possibly grab some more of this China graph. That makes sense. I don't know why it's dermatograph in here, because derma suggests that it's able to draw on a skin, while China suggests that it's able to draw on China well. So yeah, yeah, it was really fun, like talking about all my fails in Sims and my fail first night when the robber just came. I was scarred for life, like really. After that, I haven't mentioned that, but after that I just ditched the family and never came back because I saved just before the robber came, and every time I came back the music, this scary music just played again and again, and I was too scared to come back and face this like a grown-up woman I was at 8 years old. So yeah, it's so, like, I feel so intimidated by this picture. It's like, I feel that even if it's just one object, it's so much going on here. Like, I need to see this, like, my, a little bit before, to observe this, a little bit before I jump in. So I see that this bump goes quite halfway the height, and this bump goes a little bit on the right of the center vertical line. So yeah, a little bit of observation. Okay, so it's about 1/3 of the whole page. Like, I know, I noticed that it's much easier to draw when you have a picture beside you, because you can just like imagine the lines going from there, so you have the width of the picture, of the object, just better approximated, better grasped than if it would be just like, you know, from the screen, like measuring from the screen. So yeah, oh my god, I'm just putting the moment as much as I can. Oh my god, it's a blob on the sand. I'm scared of the blob of the sand, like, what's wrong with me? So yeah, just one quick glance of a tap. So I will be not looking at chat for the next 30 minutes. So Sam, as my only moderator for now, just take care of it while I will be gone and struggling with this monstrosity of a creature. Okay. This will be a disaster. Okay. 3, 2, 1, go! I will probably just draw like... Screw that again. Screw that. There is one bump also here that I just noticed. And some noticed I drew slime earlier, but it was all from my head. Like, if you haven't seen my slime monster, that I will maybe also grab the other sketchbook while I will be gone. So this is also little like remain here, and I will just block out some shapes of the sand. No, that's not right. Okay, so I think that the sketch is done. Now just lightly erase it. Really lightly. I just wish that the synth that is built in to read the donation and beats messages was also here to read the chat for me. It would be so good. This one is longer. I go straight to the color, like maybe not so straight to the color, but like, I don't know, and something here. And a little bit of this darkening. I will put the highlights later, hopefully. So a little bit darker. I will probably not make the exact highlight, but at least I try to make them look like believable. Like, I think that that point in doing art from doing art that is referenced heavily from a picture, like it doesn't have to look exactly, because most time the people who look at your picture didn't see the reference, or they don't see it like all the time while viewing the picture, so they can't tell that something is not right, like in the picture, like, you know. When you're drawing some random people, yeah, that's a person. And like, yeah, that's the person. And oh my god, 24 minutes. Ready? At least I will have some. Okay, so let's go to. I know that this one is more. More like C in shape. Lighter. make my moves faster if I want to color in that whole background. I feel that there is more. Oh no, I feel that the nip will break in a moment. And I can't. Oh, there will be one. I feel that this is like, you see? I hope that you see this. If the chat was out loud, like the messages on chat would be spoken, that you will just yell at me, Nina, Nina, you don't see anything. I will also go through all this black, because it's made not fully black. I think it would give a nice effect. 24. I see that there is some transparency going, so I just go through this real light, so the beige, ochre, or beige, or whatever, underneath. There are some nice swirls. Inside the jellyfish. Jellyfish are like pretty on its own, deadly, but pretty. At least the ones that we have here. I will just, oh, because I see that it's pitch dark here. And I will see the colors better. One thing I learned at art class that I went and I completely discarded right now is that for best effects, like the sketchy effects, to achieve sketchy effect, that you need to take one direction of lines and hatch only this way, unless you want to render some 3D, but it's not, but it's just optional. I knew it would happen. Okay, I will just save the nip and go here, because this shade of blue is more like, you see, more like indigo, and it will make the, like here, I see some of this, like, unless you want to render some shapes, it's more it's advised, at least it was advised for me, to, and this one is like, oh, just a regular blue. So it's a good like base color. Is it just me or the music stop? Lamp? 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 Don't die on me. Don't you even dare. 18 minutes, okay. I'll just quickly go also with this. Please stop. Like, I really believe that some appearances are just mean. Like, can you see this flickering? Like, God. Okay, and a little bit of here, because this is much lighter. So yeah, the music stopped, but I'm not going to bring it back, because no. Okay, so this is one little golden, some golden specks, maybe a little bit. No, all the sockets are in, so I don't know why this is flickering on me. And just quickly, very lightly, put the ochre. I still don't know how to do this texture. Oh my God, I hope this won't be like the last breath, like the last bright, the last brightness before the eternal darkness. Okay, and a little bit of here, here-ish. I see that I need to do some highlights here. Here-ish. And I see already that this thing is too high. Don't worry, just the case of from my needed eraser that just fell off. I hope my dog won't catch it and eat it and chew on it, because I'm just worried about him. Like, he sometimes, I'm just worried because he will just end like those poor sea creatures that are found with like lots of plastic inside the bodies. Like, it's horrible. Like, like the humans are just such as I don't know if you can hear him right now. My humor sister just showing him. Quickly, what's next? Okay, I will just put a layer of gray over everything. A little bit here, because these highlights aren't as... Oh my God, it looks so bad. I see that I need to smooth that out. just make it. I hope you can see it. No.
No.
Okay, from what I can tell, the darkening the background would help to bring that. God, 12 minutes. My arm kinda hurts. This maybe a little bit of this gray. And then I will focus on the highlights. Okay, I see that this is way too light. Way too light. Okay, so just let's go with this one. A little much lighter here. I see that I will smooth the color out, but I see this is much too bright. Just go with a little bit of black all over it. Okay, the color may be just all right. Just a little blob here and maybe here. Smooth it out real quick and then go through highlights. Smooth it out a little bit and I smooth out all. Jamie. But it looks more slimy that way. I know, I see that this part is more extreme. This should be more darkened, but it doesn't matter. Just I will scrap this 8 minutes. God damn it. And I will go and darken that. And it will, and I can already tell that it will look nothing like a sand. Put some shadows. Maybe this will help, and then quickly go to through highlights. I know you can see this, but I know that some humans, myself included, can change the focal length of their eye at will. And by that, just blur the, you know, some people squint their eyes so they can blur the picture when they draw. But some, like me, can change the focal length at will. And this is very helpful to just quickly go through the, quickly see the main shapes and values of the picture. I don't know how this looks like. Ah, it looks already so bad. Okay, highlights. Too much paint, but I don't care now. Just quickly. Quickly. Boop. Boop, boop, boop. I know that I struggle with making the proper values because I already can see that in some places the highlights are not seen because they are the background is too light to be seen. Too much dab, just gently dab, dry brush all things. Then just 3 minutes. I will go again, but I don't know with which color. Probably I will choose the Faber-Castell ones. And just quickly make the and just quickly go through the through those colors again, and again a little bit with brush. Oh no, the phone is ringing. Okay, 1 minute. I will try to darken the background even more. At least around the jellyfish. And around that little speck which I need to lighten a little bit. No, my values are off. Just make this less saturated. So here. Oh God. Gone. Done. The time is all gone. I'll just bring back the music. Well, that was an attempt. Okay, just go through the chat real quick. God, I see that so it's so much lighter. Okay, where did I? Not so awesome, not so awesome. Like, God, this one was so frustrating. I don't know which one was also that I will just quickly browse through. I think this was the first one. and I did mistake by diluting the watercolor pencil, and it just the pages, just the color of the page goes through. I just quickly see, quickly go through. I remember this one. Again, the values are so off, and the gray is way warmer than the original. Like, where is the next one? This one looks nice after I redraw it, because the first attempt was like disaster. I tried watercolors and I kind of failed. And this is the sixth one. Oh, the one I tweaked later. This one was also the frustrating one, because I seem to either go full black or too light of a gray. I think maybe this is the medium's fault, that it doesn't want to mix that well. But, and also there is one, oh, there's also this one, more comic book approach. I like it. Proportions are a little bit off. I see that that I squeezed this, or maybe not. No, I stretched this part. But yeah. I will quickly go. So yeah, not that awesome skill, because I feel I failed that one, like really badly. Nina, the colored pencil ninja, yeah, probably. Oh, thank you girls, thank you. But I don't know, I just look at this and like, like, I still struggle with how to make really deep colors with all I have. I think that, God, I don't know, maybe I should switch to paint, since this also didn't have too much colors. And with paint I could do some texture, so I don't know, maybe I will try to just put another page here and redraw and repaint it later, like much later, when all the emotions just... And look, now the lamp just works flawlessly. Like, I don't know why it flickered so much. If complementary colors would help get deeper shadows for you. Like, I mean, it's almost really gray and it's already pretty complementary. So you mean like adding some yellow here? But knowing my luck, it would just turn green. I mean, it looks, when you hide this, it kind of looks like a blob, but I don't know, these dark things kind of doesn't belong here. Now that the whole picture is pretty light, this one. Like, this picture is pretty bright and light, and this just cut off so much. Orange. Oh yeah, it's orange, yeah, right. I even have a color wheel in my other sketchbook, like, I'm sometimes so messy. Okay, where is this this little plastic box that my dog luckily haven't ate. So yeah, this is my 30 minute Monday. I will probably scan it tomorrow, because I look at the time, I will scan it tomorrow. Okay, so let's leave it. Well, it dried pretty quickly, but what to do with all this paint? I need to scrap it off once it dries and save those faulty needs. So I will just do a little break, find those, bring that one sketchbook with slime, and just kind of try to at least draw one football pose, because really, okay, so be right back. Okay, I'm back. Just this, and I found like all the colors. As you can see, these were not sharpened yet from the 80s. Like when I saw the unsharpened pencils from the 80s. That I couldn't believe this, and even there is some. I will just hope that you can see this. Oh, there is even some fabric from some factory numbers, and here, which is by the way, the info that I could find when these were produced. This is all there on this green one. They were all pretty much close to each other when my dad found them, and each of them has different, like, not all of them had those numbers. Oh, so this one is like, oh, you can see this. This one has some factory name, PZMB, which from my Googled is a Polish factory. That, and this set of China graphs is apparently from the 80s, because this is where the where the I've searched some online auctions, and the ones from the 80s were in the pretty much similar box and similar sets to these ones, and the factory produced them in the 80s. This factory is, from what I remember, it's not working now, or I don't know if it's the same factory that produced the Crayola, the Polish Crayola crayons, like the wax ones from children, for children, that but we've changed name. Like, I'll just, you know, Google this real quick, because this is like some piece of history right there. There is one like number 652 and 653, and apparently I have all the three existing colors for these things, and I haven't seen them like anywhere else. And this is like amazing. This is like, I love antique things, and to own, like, I saw people, like, I follow YouTubers called Doodle Date, and they found like a Reeves watercolor set from 30s, and it's like, oh my god, so amazing. And for watercolors, especially the good branded ones, they are still activable, and you can still paint with them after all these years. Like my crappy set, the one I use now, is the last one that I used. This before I took a break in art, I used them last in like third grade when I was 9, and then when I took up watercolors again like 1 year ago, which is like almost 15 years, they are still, well, they are crappy because they are cheap school grade for kids, but they are still workable. And this is amazing for art supplies, and I wish to find like some nice old, because the packaging is so nice in older stuff. Like, you don't get this, like, I get this tin one is amazing, but it already just, I try to fix the hinges, and every time I open it to wide, it pops out the hinges. Oh, and I need to pop this in. And I only also get this carton one, this card box, which is falling apart already. Can't get this stuff out of my head. Back to the slime. Oh yeah, here it is. So you can kind of see where I was going with the highlights and thinking about the light source, but also rendering the shape and the transparency of the slime to some extent. So yeah, so back to the football, because apparently this is all people care about in this wonderful month of June of 2018, because there is a World Cup apparently So I will just close this attempt and maybe try to just add another paper and another. Oh yeah, this is not the rubber from this sketchbook because I apparently left it in another room. This is for this one. I made this rubber myself. I just bought a regular rubber and I stitched two ends together so I can close my sketchbook. Just I consider myself a pretty handy person. Like, I like doing something with my hands because, hey, ZHOOC3Q, thank you for the follow. What kind of nick is that? Like, really? I don't know. I can't make up anything out of this nick. I was watching in the metro on my mobile. Okay. Whoa, what you were doing at this hour? Yeah, this is the wonders of a subway. Really? This is how you write Żuczek in lead speak? Like, come on. I'm not even trying. It would be it should be like this. It should be like this. This would be better to read. So yeah, back to the football players. I got some Google images open there. And really, I googled football player and half of these were not what I wanted because, you know, football in America is something different than football in the rest of the world. But soccer player gave a plenty of nice references. But I need to choose one so I won't anger any random Real or Barcelona fans that are out there. Okay, where's the one that is running? Then who chose it? It's not you. Okay, Joanna. And who chose it? It's not you. This one looks funny. I will just quickly download it and show you. Like, look. Oh, come on, go get smaller. Like, he looks like a ballerina, to be honest. So no. I don't know, there are only people like... Okay, this one looks okay, but the facial expression... And again, to all real fans, not the real fans, real fans out there, put it somewhere here. So yeah, this is quite a nice pose, I suppose. Pun not intended. I don't know, it's hard to choose. Many of them are like so basic, or the bow is like, oh, this one, I saw this earlier. I will grab this one real quick. I'll just quickly swap them, swap it. Look, it's a girl. It's a nice, the nicest pose I've found. Real rare. Are you going to give me tongue twister, Jacek? Like really, Jacek? Real rare fans are unreal. Try to repeat that 3 times. Oh, thank you, Sam. It was nice to have you there. And good luck with whatever you need to do. And see you tomorrow, because I will be tomorrow. Definitely. Like, for sure. I will be doing some other stuff, like coloring this dance skeleton. But yeah, I will be here. So thank you for coming. And bye. And we will just stay here for the, oh, I think that the my desk can just froze. Let me just see. But no, on my phone it's okay. I will just refresh it real quick. Oh, it's working now. Great. So, this is the pose I will try to like study. So I will just put it in the corner. So, and just put a bigger version here, so I can still read the chat. Oh. So yeah, this is like the person. Obvious. This is like the person. So I just measure the head to rest of the body ratio. Okay, so it's about 5. So it's like 5, and it's like head here. And still. And I know I look strange doing things like that, but it will help me measure things. So the chest ends here and is tilted like that, and the waist starts here. And around here is the hand. I'll just quickly do some. How did I measure it? I'm already 2 heads in, and the whole 1, 2, 3. Maybe I counted it wrong. Sometimes I don't count the first head as the head, so I usually need to add. So the hips line goes there. Four is under the knee. And no, it's actually 5.5. So okay. And this one is like goes, the angle is bad. I already see that. The whole body is like tilted like that. So I need to grab some action line. The hand, her right hand, ends just like the waist, so around here, and goes around like 1.5 heads. So 1.5. So. So this part is almost flat. Still the angle of the leg is like, it should be like that, not that. And this one should follow the, should be parallel, yeah, to the. Okay, welcome back. This one here and this one here. We just got almost right before I have to end. So, about in the middle of the left calf, of her left calf, is her right knee. So around here. I know that my sketches are messy and that I am really heavy-handed when it comes to sketching. But yeah, let me just grab some fine liner. And then just put a bow here, around here. Looks impressive, eyes are a bit angry and elbows smaller than in the picture. Yeah, I need to render the hands better, like better. And not make the shoulders too wide, but yeah, she is, her head is more tilted. Oh yeah, just some, I don't know who designs these balls to make some, to them just some, to just put some squiggles and random shapes and call it a day. So yeah, now some just rough lining so I can see this better. But it's already running out. I'll just see if I have. Okay. Gel pen. Okay, fine enough. And I will be. Well, it seems that it will be my first and last football pose. Because I need to end this at 10 p.m. Some wrinkles. that it should, the foot should end here, a little bit closer. I know that this hand is a little squiggle, but at this point I want to just finish this one and just some football pitch in the background, a little bit shadows. Okay. Well, I think I just squinted her. I'll just see this real quick. Yeah. Oh, maybe. Yeah, I just squinted this leg because it should be the same length as her upper body. Oh no, it is. How? I need to look at it. Not from the angle. But you're drawing real fast, like. Żuczek, you came here just to make some bad puns. And I don't know if I like it or not. So yeah, it looks kind of nice. Well, it deserves a play. Well, I think it deserves to be cut off and put in my crappy Moleskine sketchbook with other poses. But I see it's already 10 p.m. So I'll be wrapping it real soon, but there are also some things I want to show you, because some things I planned this whole soccer talk and I just dwelled into like talking and choosing the supplies for like 40 minutes. But there are some things I want to show you, because I saw the mascot for this World Cup, which is held in Russia. So I will show you it real quick, because I think this is something really interesting about mascots. Because, like, seriously, this one looks so cute. Like, I can't even. Let's put it all under the chat. Like, this is so cute. It's like some anthropomorphic wolf that's playing football, and it's like, oh, which reminded me of how much of monstrosity were the mascots we had for the European Football Championships, which was hosted by Poland and Ukraine, and these were so I don't like them. I didn't like them. Like, they were horrible. I don't know, because all the mascots were like, they look good on logo, on banners, logos, and other stuff. While I haven't seen the costume of this one, because the logo could be nice, but the costume would be... Don't come up, Żaczek, Żuczek, don't come up with Coco Coco Eurospoco here, like, no, no, they weren't, like, really. And this year's official hymn by Jason Derulo isn't any better. Like, I don't like this guy. But yeah, I will show you real quick how the Polish-Ukrainian ones looked like. Well, in theory, they were like this. You know, two boys playing football. Like, I know, I like the logo, the logotype that it's here. It's like some nice folk elements, and it looks like nice, but they are like so uninspired. And it was supposed to derive from the... I thought that they were supposed to derive from the legend of the beginnings of Slavic tribes. Like, there were those three brothers called Lech, Czech, I Rus, and each of them founded the tribe for current Czech Republic, current Poland, and current like Belarus and Ukraine and part of Russia. And this one pictured here are named Slavek and Slavko, which already this not none of these are Polish names, which is one of my biggest concerns when I heard about them. And I will show you real quick how the costumes looked like. Because this is just so, like, look, they are dead inside. Like, really. And also, there were some really shifty business around them, because people were saying that they look way too similar to the ones that were during the European Championship 4 years earlier, because they are just like World Cup. The European Championship is held every 4 years, but with the break of 2 years between, like, you know, there is Summer Olympics and Winter Olympics, and European World Cup is held the same year, always the same year as Summer Olympics, and the World Cup is held the same year as Winter Olympics. So these are the ones from 2008. I will just readjust them. So yeah, this is where the Switzerland and Austria were the hosts. But look how much fun they have. Poland is going to break Ukraine's knee. Yeah, the poses could be better. But they were sometimes better. Sometimes they were just standing. So, but my phone again just stopped adjusting, because I'm waving my hand in front of the camera, and just it won't. I will just quickly It's good now. And so people were telling that, oh yeah, we're just borrowing the idea for mascots from the last hosts. But to be honest and to give the justice, the costumes weren't that great either. Like, look at them. So bad, so bad. And I just hope that they will make the costume better. I will see. Hopefully, they will show the full mascot in costume during the opening ceremony on Thursday. But yeah, so bad. No, let's stick to the raw football. I see that the picture, that the camera is lagging quite a bit, but it's already time to end this stream, and I will just quickly show what I had done during this one, if I can find it again. So yeah, just adjust it. Yeah, I feel so old when I just realized that 2008 was like 10 years ago, and I'm like, but I just didn't I graduated high school like 2 years ago? No. So this is what we did on the last stream. On this stream, yeah. So I think I will wrap this before anybody will scream at me to let go of the kitchen and let them come in. So yeah, thank you for coming. Finally, a stream that I don't and talking to a void and the whooping zero viewers, yay! So yeah, the next one will be at Friday or Saturday at 8 PM CEST. I haven't decided on a day yet, probably one of these two. And I think we'll continue with the football theme because I want to make and another thing from this book, which is football themed, and well, an occasion like World Cup happens only once a four years. So I need to use this as much as I can and put football in tax and get more money. Ha ha ha! Except not. So yeah, thank you for coming, thank you for watching. If you're watching this later or if you're watching this on YouTube, I will post this thing like tomorrow and maybe work on this again tomorrow. I don't know, I haven't decided yet. So yeah, thank you very much for coming and good night. To the next time. So yeah, thank you again and bye.